1971, music critic Robert Christgau likened Roberta Flack's voice to that of someone saying, "Between you and I." Take a moment and picture someone saying this phrase to you. They lean in, eyes softening, and say it, not in a whisper, but somehow quiet, clear, and confident. Perhaps you feel an immediate sense of trust, of intimacy. And above all, you feel as if you're about to hear something special. And that is precisely the feeling that Roberta Flack's music has given listeners for over 5 decades. Raised in a musical household in North Carolina and Virginia, Flack's early childhood was steeped in a love for hymns, spirituals, and gospel music. Fostered by her mother, Irene, who was a church organist. By age 9, she began playing piano, showing a deep talent for classical traditions. And by age 15, was given a full scholarship to Howard University, becoming one of the youngest students in the college's history. The seeds of her exceptional career were sown at Howard. In addition to her classical training on piano, she studied voice, served as an assistant choir director, began teaching at a nearby school, and befriended fellow classmate and future soul legend, Donny Hathaway. The two would go on to regularly collaborate until Hathaway's untimely death in 1979, spawning gold-selling hits, such as The Closer I Get to You and the Grammy-winning Where Is the Love? But before the mega-hit songs, Flack was paying her dues in her own way. During the day, she could be found in the music classrooms of junior high schools in the Washington, D.C. area, and giving piano lessons on the side. On weekends, she accompanied opera singers at local nightclubs, often playing blues and jazz numbers in the club's back rooms during intermission. It was in these clubs that she'd be discovered, eventually landing a label deal with Atlantic Records. Two of Flack's best-known songs of all time found their origins not in a raucous nightclub, but in the intimate setting of a car and an airplane. In 1972, Clint Eastwood was driving down the LA freeway when "The First Time Ever I Saw Your Face" came on the radio. Flack later recounted that the actor-director was so mesmerized by my performance, he almost drove into a ditch. He knew instantly that the ethereal ballad needed to be in his next film. The song was later named by Billboard as the top song of the year, and from there, Flack's career was sent into the stratosphere. A couple years later, Flack was on a plane when Lori Lieberman's jazzy folk tune, "Killing Me Softly with His Song," played through the audio program. Putting her musical training to use, Flack transcribed what she heard, daydreaming about an arrangement that would go on to push the song into the serene, almost haunting version that would become her second number one hit. Not only did the song win 2 Grammys in 1974, it won yet another one in 1996 for the version by the Fugees, led by singer and rapper Lauryn Hill. Flack's eclectic style skillfully mixes blues, jazz, folk, pop, R&B, and soul into a smoldering sound that defies categorization and has spawned number one hits, Grammys, and American Music Awards. Her dedication to education continued with the inception of the Roberta Flack School of Music in the Bronx and with the Roberta Flack Foundation, which supports music education programs, as well as animal welfare, another issue close to her heart. With such a diverse career that spans the last 50 years, the spark that ignites it all is her artistic versatility. From church pews to green rooms, classrooms to concert halls, Roberta Flack brings her quiet fire to wherever we are.
The first time. This whole life thing, it's rehearsed. We rehearse our joy. We rehearse our pain. We rehearse our laughter. We rehearsed love. And our fears were lines fed to us by casting directors before our insecurities landed us the part. It's all rehearsed. It's all scenes we've studied, never things we've lived. Why do we rehearse? Hurry, before you miss your cue. We're just understudies of the lives we want to live, but are too afraid to break character for. Wake up!
Most iconic and beloved voices in all of history, in America, and in the world. We are beyond honored to be giving tribute to her tonight, to revel in her music once more. Unfortunately, Ms. Flack is unable to join us in person tonight, but we do know that she's watching from home, and we hope that she's enjoying our presentation of some of her most signature works. On behalf of the cast of the 2023 Berklee Commencement Concert, we would like to say thank you, Roberta Flack. Thank you for your artistry, your leadership, your example, and offering your music and yourself to generations of musicians and music lovers all over the world. All of our lives have been made better because of you and your career. You sang, "Where is the love?" And for decades, so many of us have been able to find a little bit of that love through your music. Berklee graduates, friends, family, please join me in showing our appreciation for one of the most beloved artists of all time, the incomparable Roberta Flack.
with his song. I heard he sang a song.
time will mend the broken heart until I swear to stop and start. Am I the slave when it's time for
then
The job
of the West African griot. Storyteller, musician, historian, poet, the griot tradition goes back centuries and remains an integral part of African cultural identity. But preserving a heritage is not the whole story. Gambian multi-instrumentalist Sona Jobarteh has been adding her own chapters to the story and spreading its message throughout the world since her first performance at the age of 4 at London's famed Jazz Cafe. Born into one of the 5 principal kora playing families in West Africa, Jobarteh made history as the first woman to become a professional kora player, a skill traditionally handed down from father to son. Beyond her virtuosic skill on the 21-stringed harp-like kora, Jobarteh studied cello, piano, and harpsichord at the Purcell School of Music and Royal College of Music in the United Kingdom. She has released 3 studio albums of original work, the latest of which, Badenya Kumu, was named one of the best albums of 2022 and a top of the world pick by Songlines. She has also contributed to the soundtrack for films such as Beast, Mami Wata, and Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom. In 2010, she composed the score for Motherland, a documentary that chronicles the history and culture of Africa through a distinctly African perspective. Jobarteh avoided the use of Western stringed instrumentation, instead focusing on a range of African instruments that not only fit with the film's themes, but was an innovation in the world of cinematic music. This Afrocentric lens is central to Jobarteh's work, not just as a musician, but as a social activist, humanitarian, and educator. In 2015, she founded the Gambia Academy, a school that centers African music, dance, and culture among its full range of academic offerings. The school's mission is dedicated to reversing colonial influence on African education and taking an immersive approach to learning. The Academy's teaching philosophy states that students must be shown, not just told, how things work in the real world. And as Jobarteh has said, I'm always encouraging tradition to be innovative and to be made relevant and kept modern. With her innovations in music and education in mind, it would be technically correct to call Jobarteh an entrepreneur, but that term feels too distant from her deeply rooted context. Rather, this insistence on keeping her culture alive and vital is in fact very much aligned with her griot lineage. Regarding griot culture in general, the Senegalese griot and percussionist Paco Sam has said, "Any country you go to, you share your family with them." In that sense, Jobarteh has shared her family the world over, to which as anyone who has listened to her music can attest, especially if you've had the awe-inspiring pleasure of hearing it live. And yet, even with a decades-long career that has expanded the creative possibilities of kora music, and with her deep commitment to education and social activism, Jobarteh has notably said, "I believe the story is not yet done. The griot keeps the story alive." Sona Jobarteh is giving that story new life.
Thank you. Bangko di mana mume Thank you. Thank you. sin aver andado. Ah, ubi mi lungo andado. Ah, sin aver andado. Ah, ubi mi lungo andado. Ah, sin aver andado. Ah, ubi mi lungo andado.
julelema
Juliana Jula que la bana ya nyonde Juliana Juliana Jula mucho la bana ya nyonde Juliana
Juliana mu bana ya ti
Juliana nin bana ya lo
Juliana mu bana ya ti
una ni bana ya te du kere poro ya Juliana mu bana ya ti
Berklee graduates, friends, and families, we invite you to show your appreciation and welcome to our stage the international superstar, female kora artist from Gambia, activist, educator, innovator, entrepreneur, and humanitarian, the new griot, Sona Jobarteh!
Thank you. They said take my time, so I'm taking my time. So. Thank you so much, Berklee. It's beautiful to be here tonight. I thought I wasn't gonna make it, but I literally just made it, and I'm gonna run as soon as I finish playing, unfortunately, to take a flight to somewhere. Thank you. The next place. But what's important is I'm here tonight. That's what's important, right? I'm gutted that I'm not gonna see the last tribute tonight. You guys, I know, are gonna rock it. Usher, beautiful, amazing. So my heart is with you. I'll be on a flight, but I'll be thinking, oh, my spirit will be here, definitely. So thank you so much for the support to Berklee. I often say, when you work hard, you don't really sometimes take a moment to look up and check where you are until someone says, oh, you're here. So this is what Berklee did for me. They told me, oh, you're here. So I'm like, okay, I'm here. I'm here.
Thank you.
So this song I'm going to play, and the tribute was amazing. I want to actually take this moment to say thank you to all the students here tonight who have done an amazing job for all of us. Please give it up for the students of Berklee, an amazing job. This is an honor for me, you know, this instrument here, kora, for those, they said take my time, I like talking, right? This is a kora from West Africa, Gambia, Senegal, Mali, Guinea-Bissau. It is good, it's like super good, right? As I said, this is a very ancient tradition, one that goes back more than 700 years. And for the past seven centuries, this tradition has been handed down from generation to generation, father to son. And it's been done just within five families. And these families are called griot families. My family, Jobarteh, is one of these families that have been keeping this tradition alive for more than 700 years. And I inherited this tradition from my father, who inherited it from his father and his father, and so on. But there is a break in the line. Many people say that I have broken tradition by being the first female in this line. However, I say I'm not breaking tradition, I'm maintaining tradition. So this is my role. I say that every tradition has a purpose in this world. Music must be relevant to the society. And although there was a reason why men were the custodians of this tradition 700 years ago, there is no reason why women do not now have a role in this tradition in 2023. Amen. So this is my role here today, maintaining tradition. I'm having a little technical fault, that's why I'm talking long, right? This is what I'm here today. This song we're gonna play here for tonight to close is called Musolou. Musolou, it means women. And I wrote this song because I'm a female, because I'm a woman in an ancient tradition, and there are many, many women out there among the world who are also pioneers, entrepreneurs, role models. And I dedicate this song to every single woman, great and small, no matter who you are, where you are in the world, this song is for you, for women of the world. I'm gonna ask you to join us at the end, all right? The words, so you know, Musolou al-na. It means women, come together. Musolou al-na. Let's do it again. Musolou al-na.
Musolou al-na.
And then this one you add, eh. It's just like, yeah, eh, eh. Ghana, if there's any Ghanaians here, you know, eh, it means yes, all right? So Musolou al-na, ehe. That's it. At the end, I will call on you for that. Voila, my sound is there. Good. Front of house, you have me? Kora, you have me? Can you put a thumb up if you have me at the front? You know, this instrument, it doesn't like to travel. That's his problem. It gets problematic. You know, these things are used to sitting under a baobab tree in the middle of the village, you know. People like me who want to take it around the world, it's that's complaining. Do you have me at the front now, sound man? I'm not getting a thumbs up, so. Give it up for this guy. He's gonna stay there for this one.
Thank you.
Let's send this from Berklee to the Gambia. One more. Musolou Allah, eh, eh. Put your hands together. Voila. Musolou Allah, eh, eh. Thank you so much once again, Berklee. A big shout out to Usher here tonight. Big shout out to LL Cool J here tonight. And a big shout out to Roberta Flack, where you are in the world. Thank you so much once again. Honored to be here. I hope to see you again sometime soon. Thank you.
Give it up one more time for Miss Sonia Jobarteh and the Berklee students. I'm a big fan, so I have to make it a point to, you know, get a selfie. So I'll take advantage of that. So my name is Sean Skeets. I'm the interim dean of the Professional Performance Division. And I want to welcome you once again to Berklee's 2023 Commencement Concert. This is my house. So welcome. Great to see you all. What a wonderful celebration of these incredible artists by our students, honorary doctorate recipients. So it wasn't long ago that I was a Berklee student, just like you see up here, full of hopes and dreams, bugging my parents, telling them what I wanted to do in life, with the hope of inspiring people with my art and with my music. And those dreams were fueled by my loved ones, my family, my friends that pushed me to carry on. So I just want to acknowledge the loved ones, the friends, and the families that are here that are supporting these students. You all are incredible. You all are incredible. The commencement concert showcases some of Berklee's finest artists from around the institution, including vocalists, rappers, spoken word performers, instrumentalists, arrangers, conductors, track production assistants, dancers, choreographers, and VJ designers. In fact, there are more than 200 students from over 40 countries represented here on stage and backstage. Aren't y'all just proud of them? These are our students. These are our students. Incredible. The concert also features collaboration with the Boston Conservatory at Berklee's Dance Division with, yeah, give it up. Give it up. Give it up. Also, the contemporary commercial dance programs are represented, in addition to dancers from the college, along with choreographers and faculty and a student team. And I just want to thank you all one more time for being here this evening. And my understanding is that the board chair, Marty Mannion, is here. So Marty, if you're here, please stand and be recognized. And I'd also like to invite the Board of Trustees to stand and be recognized. Thank you all so much. We really appreciate you all. I'm glad you're here celebrating with us. So now it's my distinct pleasure to introduce the third honoree, the video of the third honoree, the man that has brought us, and because there's so many hits, I just need to bring a little list. The man that has brought us, yeah. You got it bad. My boo. Good kisser. nice and slow. You remind me. Confessions. And they're like, yeah, what y'all confessing? And many others. Please join me in welcoming this next video. Let's give it up for the incredible artist, Usher.
If I'm gonna tell it, then I gotta tell it all. So goes a line from Usher's song, Confessions, Part 2, which could be seen as a motto for his career as one of the most versatile singers in pop, R&B, soul, and electronic music over the last 3 decades. The lyric speaks to Usher's power, not just as a show-stopping vocalist, but as a storyteller who won't shy away from honesty in its boldest forms, from the raw to the vulnerable. Delivered with a silken tone that dips and climbs vocal runs with ease, Usher's voice always commits to every note, grabbing our attention, not letting us go until he has, in fact, told it all. One song, of course, can't tell the whole story. Neither can one album. Even if that album is the Diamond Certified Confessions, with its 3 Grammys, 4 American Music Awards, and 11 Billboard Music Awards. The 4 Confessions singles alone spent a combined total of 28 weeks in the #1 spot on the Billboard Hot 100. Let that sink in. 7 months. This means that Usher spent more than half of 2004 as the #1 artist in America. It would be more than understandable if Confessions was the pinnacle of Usher's imperial era, but his next 3 albums all debuted at #1 on the Billboard Top 200. From being signed on the spot when he was only 14 by legendary label executive L.A. Reid to his latest single, Glue, released not even 2 months ago, his career has refused to be defined by just one peak. Usher Raymond IV was born in Dallas, Texas, and raised in Chattanooga, Tennessee. After his family recognized his artistic potential, they moved to Atlanta, Georgia when Usher was 12, believing he'd have more professional opportunities there. Their instincts were quickly proven right, as within 2 years, Usher had been signed to LaFace Records, the hitmaker label that would launch legendary careers from TLC, Outkast, Pink, Goody Mob, and more. In 1998, Usher scored his first #1 hit in America with a sensual, slow jam, Nice and Slow, which, appropriately for the song, reached the top of the charts on Valentine's Day of that year. There would be nothing nice and slow about his trajectory from there, however. Over the course of 8 studio albums, Usher has earned 8 Grammy Awards and sold more than 80 million units, leading the Recording Industry Association of America to name him one of the best-selling artists in American music history. His artistry has made a huge impression on the wider pop, hip-hop, R&B, and electronic music landscape, as he has influenced the likes of Drake, Trey Songz, Justin Bieber, Anderson .Paak, Zayn Malik of One Direction, and Jungkook of BTS, among many, many others. His legacy extends far beyond music. As a film and television actor, he's been a judge for The Voice, portrayed legends such as Sugar Ray Leonard in Hands of Stone, and Marvin Gaye in American Dreams. And in the movie Muppets Most Wanted, he played the role of, well, a wedding usher. As a humanitarian and social activist, Usher has raised tens of millions of dollars through his New Look Foundation, which provides opportunities for underserved youth. And he was directly involved in rehousing projects in the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. His devotion to social change often shows up in his music, with songs such as Hush and Chains that address issues such as voting rights and victims of violence. Rumor has it that Usher is currently at work on his 9th album. And we know that if he's gonna tell it, he's gonna tell it all once again. We can't wait to listen.
Doing the mind. every lover, y'all. In and out of my life, I've hid love and every tears without care. Until I met this girl who turned the tables around. She caught me by surprise, and I never thought I'd be the one breaking down. I can't figure it out, why I'm so caught up. You got me feeling it. Comes back around, same old song, but I was so sure that wouldn't happen to me, cause I don't want to put it down, but I was so wrong, if this girl was me, she really turned me down. My body was so tight, looking for in the daytime with a flashlight, my homie said, this girl is grand in my style.
Like it's the last night of your life. I'm gonna this is what you do, hey, yeah, oh.
Hey, I just wanna take it. Baby, tell me what you want with me.
Guessing that it's true. Baby, holler and I bet I need it. Goddess, don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Baby. Don't nobody kiss it like you. Don't nobody kiss it like you.
It's 5 in the morning, cause she's rolling. Well, she making steak and eggs. Yeah.
I'll be checking you out when you be putting your heels on.
body so perfect, baby. How you work it, baby. I love the way that you be poking it out, girl. Give me something to feel on. So please believe we gon' be twerking it out by the end of the night. Around you. Our first time every time we get together. Baby, loving you feels better than everything, anything. Put on my heart, you don't need a ring. And I promise our time away won't change my life. There goes my baby.
Sexy pop, pop, popping, dropping, dropping low. Never ever has a lady hit me on the first sight. This was something special. This was just like dynamite. Honey got a booty like
wow, wow, wow.
Honey got some boobies like
wow, oh, wow.
Girl, you know I'm loving your style. Check, 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 checking you out like. So many ways to love ya, baby, I can break you down. There's so many ways to love ya, got me like
like, hey!
Berklee, let me hear you make some noise. If you enjoy this concert, let me hear you say, yeah. If you enjoy this concert, let me hear you say, yeah. Berklee graduates, friends and family, I am honored to show our love and appreciation to one of the most beloved and successful artists of this generation. Yep. Could you join me, please, in welcoming the 8-time Grammy Award winning singer, actor, dancer,
what else?
Philanthropist,
activist.
Watch this. Ladies and gentlemen, get out your seat and on your feet and make some noise for the one and only Usher!
Congratulations, my brother.
want you to feel every word that I'm singing, all right? This one's for you, Usher.
It's gonna burn for me to say this, but it's coming from my heart. It's been a long time coming, but we done been fell apart. I really wanna work this out, but I don't think you're gonna change yet. I do, but you don't. Think it's best we go our separate ways. Tell me what I should say in this relationship. When I'm hurting, baby, I ain't happy, baby. Plus, there's so many other things I gotta deal with. I think that you should
let it burn when the feeling lanes.
But you know, you gotta let it go.
I'm twisted cause one side of me is telling me that I need to move on. On the other side, I want to break down and cry. Ooh, I'm twisted cause one side of me is telling me that I need to move on. On the other side, I want to break down and cry, yeah.
I'm your girl, you're my man. Promise.
I'll take blame. Can't accept that we're a stranger without you. Without you.
Listen, this is a lot, and I really do appreciate it. To all of the Berklee students, to each and every one of the faculty that had any part to do with this, man, you know what, we can break it all the way down. We can stop it, right? No. So I'm floored. I don't really know what to say. But I was a bit worried about you guys. I was looking out in the audience like, I didn't make all these songs for you to sit down. But it would be fitting to say something good. So here's what I'm going to say. Something simple. They call me D-O-C-T-O-R-R-A-Y-M-O-N-D. Now, baby, tell me what you want to do with me. Dr. Raymond, ladies and gentlemen.
I can tell you.
Thank you. I love y'all, man. Thank you so much. 1, 2, 3, let's go.
Thank you. celebration this year with the brand new BFA in Commercial Dance Program at the Boston Observatory at Berklee. Introducing our brilliant Berklee Presents student choreographers. We'd like to give a special thank you to our guest choreographers from the Boston Conservatory at Berklee, Anthony Burrell, Joel Kamala, and Heather Easley. Yeah, 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 hey, hey, hey. Put your hands together for our horn section. Our incredible string section. And keep the love going for our production team. Hey, 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 hey. Keep the energy going, y'all. Now, give it up for our special instruments.
Keeping us all locked in, we have our drummer! you so much. Thank you to our crew, the sound, lighting, video, staging, and everyone behind the scenes who helped make this concert possible. Let's give it up for them. Yeah? Thank you to our honorees, Roberta Flack, Jobarteh, and Usher. Thank you to our friends and our families here tonight and those watching online. Give it up for yourselves. Now, they've been working hard for us.